Good evening. My name is David Lamont, and I'm here at Bolling Hall in Bradford. Currently, approximately 30 people are walking around this wonderful building looking for ghosts and spirits. I'm just about to join them.
So here I am with three lovely ladies. This is Bev, this is Janine, and that's Hannah on the end. And they work for?
Angelic Paranormal.
Angelic Paranormal. Tell us all about Angelic Paranormal. Bev, what do you do?
Oh, we investigate old premises. We take people in to see if we can make contact with spirit that reside in the premises.
Wow, and how often does that happen? How many spirits have you seen?
Oh, what, loads. In this place?
Yeah.
There's been loads going on tonight.
Has there?
There has.
Welcome to the warm kitchen at Bolling Hall in Bradford. I had no idea why they called it the warm kitchen when I walked in here, because it's really cold. Until I saw this, obviously where they used to cook the food. Next door to us is the cold kitchen. So, let's go and have a rummage around in the cold kitchen, see what we can find, before we catch up with our guests, who are currently walking around the rooms upstairs. Welcome to the cold kitchen. And it is cold in here. Apparently, this is where they used to hang meat and store food, as there's no fire in here. And it is mighty cold. And there's a really odd smell to the place. Like, I can't put my finger on it, but really odd. I wonder what our guests are doing upstairs.
It's almost like a bathroom window would be. Well,
it's just right into that window.
It's like a car park, but I would say it's probably like a main kitchen.
Now, what would have been good?
Blanche. Come on down and get it. Was it just his legs showing that? He was
still
there. I want you to show you, to show us that you are here. Give us a sign. You can knock on something, knock on the wall, or knock on the floor.
Do it again.
So I'm back in the warm kitchen now with the lovely Maria Stoyles. And Maria is a spiritualist medium who's been walking around the building tonight. What have you seen, Maria?
I've seen a few things. At first it took me a little while to get used to the energies because there's a lot of activity with the people walking around in the building.
Uh-huh.
But once we start get settled down, we did experience some I experienced some visual of a lady.
Wow.
And I have no knowledge of Bolling Hall. When I do my investigations, I always ask for no one to give me any information. So it was like when I stepped through the door, it was the experiences that I were getting in, the anxiety and fear and also excitement.
Wow.
And I described the lady that came forth, and she put her face right close to my face, and I started to describe the energy. And then Janine, who is one of the ladies running the group, she showed me the actual photo or painting on the landing on the staircase, which was really interesting.
Wow.
We also went up into the attic area, which was very interesting. We saw loads of moving flashing lights in there.
Looking around the cold kitchen, I look to my right and there's a mangle. Up above there, there's a creel. And over in the corner, a butter churn. Anything in this room needed to be done at really low temperature. And there's also a really odd feeling about this room. More so than the warm kitchen. I think it's time to go.
I personally picked up on a well that is apparently attached to the building, and I could see like children being either dropped or thrown or fallen into the well.
So
it's actually very interesting because I didn't know that there was a well attached, and then I was shown during the break where the well was, which is nice proof to me that I was linking into the right energies.
So I guess I'd just been doing a little protection prayer in the other room to protect them from the evil spirits that may roam this place. So I just took a little detour into a side room. And it feels really eerie. And it has that smell. These old buildings have such a wonderful, oldie-worldy smell to them. I think it's time. I think it's time to have a chat with our guests. And see if they have encountered any darkly, ghastly spirits tonight.
Next up, I have the lovely Sandra and Lee. You've been taking part in the ghost hunt tonight, haven't you?
We have, yes.
How have you found it?
Very interesting. I've done some ghost walks before and ghost tours. I did one at Oakwell Hall, and this is sort of on a par with it. In fact, I think it's even better.
Really?
We did have some activity in the Civil War room, and when we were doing the contact board, we contacted a lady that was actually called Karen.
Karen.
An unusual name, and she died in childbirth in her 30s. And then when we went to the nursery, we were trying to get the children to move the marbles and that kind of thing, but they weren't playing with us tonight. They just didn't want to know.
And as I walked through the bedroom, once again, just a really odd feeling. I didn't see anything. I didn't smell anything, but just a really odd feeling, as if somebody was in the room with me. So, now I've got some protection, and I'm ready for them. Come on, spirits.
Wow, I bet you've seen some really kooky stuff in your time, haven't you?
It's not only a matter of seeing it, we've got pulling hair, pushing.
Really?
Calling us.
Yeah. I've walked into a couple of rooms myself, and you walk in and without seeing anything, just a feeling, just like a really odd type of, you know...
Yeah.
Ooh,
atmosphere.
Atmosphere, yeah. And I've really picked up on that tonight. And I'm not a psychic, but, you know, I can tune in little bits. So, yeah, absolutely. How have the guys and gals loved it? Have they enjoyed it?
They seem to be really enjoying themselves.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a very interesting night. I'm a developing medium myself, and I've been on several ghost hunts prior and worked as a medium on them.
Yeah.
Bolling Hall holds a very special place for me. I live very local, and I used to come here quite a lot when I was a child.
Mm-hmm.
So I know a lot of the stories and the spirits that are here.
So, how long are you going to leave me down here for?
Well, not long. We're just going to go and have a cup of tea.
And how long is that going to take?
Half an hour, maybe.
Half an hour? Thanks. Half an hour? This is more like a lifetime. I'm glad I've got you, Mr. Cameron, to talk to. This is really spooky down here, man. You know, and I'm quite a brave chap, but... Oh. Now, I hope the camera picked that up. Because I did. Must be a creaky floorboard. Okay. Right. Now I think it's time that I left. Rob! Okay, game over. That's it. I'm not staying down here a minute longer. Done.
Whose idea was that then? Hilarious. Absolutely hilarious that was. Half an hour. You look at me, look at me. Look at the state of me. How can I interview anybody now like that?
Been locked in the cellar for an hour. Hello. Anyway, I've walked up the stairs and found this beautiful bedroom with a beautiful bed inside it with a crown on the top. Look at that. That's amazing. I wonder if royalty slept in that bed. You never know. But whoever did, I bet they had some fun on it.
Now, this room is quite something. I have a very, very limited psychic ability, and I've got alarm bells going off in my head at the minute. This is not a nice room to be in at all. Very, very creepy, very, very eerie, very dark. I don't want to spend too much time in here. Not one bit.
How old were you when you first discovered that you had this gift?
I've always worked with spirits since I was very young, but I never really knew what it was about. And when I moved to England from Germany and started going to spiritualist churches and centres, that's when I recognised what my abilities were, and that's how I developed them to become a spiritualist medium.
Wow, an amazingly talented lady.
Thank
Love
you.
To meet you.
Thank you, Celia.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us. Thank you from Keith, and thank you from Rob, and thank you from me, and go and find some more ghosties.
We're going.
Yay!
Thank you very much. I'd like to thank UKN TV for locking me in the cellar for an hour. That wasn't funny. And revenge is a dish best served cold. So thank you for viewing, and until next time, this is David Lamont saying adios.